Math is a major problem for many people.
F.
Other folks seem to be almost supernaturally gifted when it comes to numbers. If you aren't naturally blessed in this department, does that mean you're going to be one-upped by math wizards for your whole entire life?
This equation is never true. It looks very simple, but in mathematics, proving that something doesn't exist is always harder than proving that something exists.
Well, don't worry about it, because you can actually improve your math abilities in several ways. Many people believe math is a skill you can learn through hard work and practice. At the very least, there are reportedly lots of little things that anyone can do in order to improve their math abilities. And it starts with picking up some basic foundational skills. According to Science, start with memorization. Although the school system seems to discourage memorization as a way to learn spelling and math, it can work. It's sound advice, so how about memorizing your multiplication tables first? Let's say through 12. Does anyone know why that's a good idea? Here's the answer. Down the line, this will simplify the process of performing more complex equations, which in turn will allow you to take on more complicated problems. Think about any skill you've learned. Do you think about all the individual processes required to walk down the street? Do you think about lifting one leg after another, bending at the knee while you're swinging your arms side to side? No, you don't. You just walk because your mind has grouped the basic processes into one fluid action. That's why memorization and rote repetition is so important with math. It helps transform a bunch of complicated components into one smooth, effortless action. It's just like learning how to walk. You need to practice, practice, practice the math skill you're going to use, just like you're learning a new language.
È molto pericoloso, signorina. Molto pericoloso.
In fact, many well-regarded scientists actually consider mathematics to be a language. Galileo once said, "The universe cannot be read until we have learned the language and become familiar with the characters in which it's written. It is written in mathematical language." Meet Barbara Oakley, the author of A Mind for Numbers, How to Excel at Math and Science, Even If You Flunked Algebra. In an article she wrote for Nautilus, Oakley points out that, in the current educational climate, memorization and repetition are often seen as demeaning and a waste of time for students and teachers alike. Oakley goes on to note that American mathematics education tends to emphasize active discussions over repetition, which is the equivalent of learning a large vocabulary of words in a foreign language but never trying to speak that language fluently.
Sandwich. Do you have a cheese sandwich?
Oakley writes that, "There is an interesting connection between learning math and science and learning a sport. When you learn how to swing a golf club, you perfect that swing from lots of repetition over a period of years. Your body knows what to do from a single thought, one chunk, instead of having to recall all the complex steps involved in hitting a ball." There's no reason to look down on educational systems that make students spend hours going over problems again and again. This model of learning emphasizes fluency, which ultimately helps your brain group more complex problems and equations into chunks, the same way we learn letters, then words, sentences, and paragraphs.
D-O-G. Dog.
As Oakley told Forbes in 2016, "I'm becoming increasingly convinced that chunking is the mother of all learning, or at least the fairy godmother. Chunking is what happens when you know something so well, like a song or a scientific formula or a verb conjugation or dance routine, that it's basically a snap to call it to mind and do it or use it." In a 2015 Google talk, Oakley argued that,
"But what you're really doing when you're learning and mastering a topic is you are in some sense creating a library of chunks."
Oakley went from being a 26-year student of foreign language who avoided math at all costs to a college professor of engineering. Her story is proof that you don't need to limit yourself based on what you think you can and can't do. Immersion is the quickest path to fluency, and if we consider math a language, immersion is essential. So how can we begin to immerse ourselves in math day to day? Start by removing your math crutches, like digital clocks and other tools that perform simple calculations for you.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5 Newtons. Now can I have one?
Your brain is a muscle, and it needs to be worked out. Be accountable. Do your homework, but because it's what will ultimately give you the experience needed to become fluent in the language of math. Will this strategy work? You can count on it.
22,200. 22,220.
And when you get a question wrong, don't beat yourself up. Figure out why. By doing this thoroughly, you'll ensure that you don't repeat the same mistakes.
Even if you were right, that would be 1 plus 1 plus 2 plus 1, not 1 plus 2 plus 1 plus 1.
Okay, fine. 1 plus 2 plus 1.
Soon enough, your skills will vastly improve.
1, 2, 3, 4,
Doug, if I might.
When all else fails, don't be afraid to ask for help. Education.com emphasizes the importance of being willing to ask for assistance when you're stumped. Otherwise, your misunderstandings will snowball over time. Take some advice from Pochin Lo, the national coach for the U.S. International Math Olympiad team.
If you just constantly challenge and enjoy the love of doing better today than you did yesterday, then you will be on an onward march towards success.
There's nothing to be ashamed of when you're trying to learn, and asking questions is the fastest way to begin understanding. And now, grab your pencils. We're going to give you a surprise pop quiz.
You can't do that!
No, we can't, but we would if the technology was there. In conclusion, keep this in mind. Performing the basic skills of memorization and repetition in a way that will help you chunk your learning will ultimately help you form a foundation that can be built upon over time. Then you'll be well on the path to success, you genius. All right, let's get started right now. Check out one of our newest videos right here. Plus, even more grunge videos about your favorite stuff are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.